For years, we have followed the story of Zach Sobiech. The Lakeland teenager died in 2013 of a rare bone cancer, but not before he brought the world his signature song, Clouds. Last year, that song and story made it to Hollywood with a movie based on Zach's life released on Disney+. And through all of these developments, Zach's mother, Laura, has learned about dealing with the curveballs of life, a perspective she's been sharing more often in this time of pandemic and polarization. Here's Carla Holt.
And Laura Sobiech joins us now. Thank you so much, Laura, for taking some time to be with us today. We really appreciate it. You know, so many of us have been going through unique experiences during this pandemic, but you bring a perspective that really is informed by the journey you shared and you traveled with Zach. Given that, can you share a little bit about what people could know and should know about how to approach this difficult time?
Yeah, I mean, our journey with Zach through childhood cancer, there are a lot of similarities to what people are going through now. Just the basics, like we had to wear masks all the time. And Zach especially, you know, he just had so much of his personal freedom taken away because, you know, oftentimes he had to be plugged into a wall and wasn't able to see friends and even family sometimes because he was vulnerable to that. So we certainly understand that part of it. I think one of the big lessons that we learned as a family and I learned as a mother was just sometimes we have to be willing to sort of let go of our own plans of how life is going to go. I think sometimes when we get too set in our ways of, okay, this is what life is going to look like and this is what I'm going to do. And, you know, you focus toward that, which is all good. We need to set goals. We have to plan, you know, we're human. But sometimes life doesn't allow that. And I think we just really need to be conscious of those times when we need to pivot and be malleable in those times. Just be kind of let go and see where life takes you. Sometimes we need to do that.
I think that's such a rich suggestion to just let go, recognize where your control ends. Again, we're going through difficult times with the pandemic. We're also going through some polarization with our politics. Any advice on that front as we see the world a little bit maybe chaotic and what we, again, can do to safeguard our hearts and our personal home?
Right. I think we are just at a very unique time in history where we are invited to step in and do what we can to help. But we also have to be careful to recognize our own limitations and set some boundaries up for that. Right. So for us, when Zach was sick, you know, we had to be careful about how far we stretched our energy because we had something very big happening in our home and we needed to focus on that. So I think for what's happening in the world today, I think it's important to be engaged and be knowledgeable about what's going on and to do what we can to help make the world better. But we also have to be careful about retreating when it gets to be too much.
I would be remiss if I didn't ask you about the year of 2020, which was so difficult in many respects, but it also gave the world a new opportunity to see Zach through the movie Clouds, obviously, that came out on Disney Plus. And how was that for you? How was that overall experience from the premiere to knowing that the rest of the world is now seeing your son in a different and beautiful light?
Yeah, I think that's kind of actually a really great example for what we were just talking about. Like, it was a really cool thing. But the plan, the way it panned out, didn't look like we thought it was going to. We thought we were going to be in theaters and things like that. And that didn't happen. But I still get to hear from people all over the world who've been touched by Zach's story in such huge ways.
Beautiful for all of us in your greater village, no question. Well, thank you so much, Laura, for taking the time today. We really appreciate your wisdom, as always.
Thank you, Carla.